Hi, I'm Margina Dennis. I've been a working makeup artist in the production industry for over 20 years. I'm also a certified COVID-19 compliance officer, also known as a health safety officer. As a fellow makeup artist, I've had to change how I go about approaching doing my job in a COVID world. Why? So that I can not only minimize the exposure for myself and the person sitting in my chair, but also cut down on the amount of time I need to spend post-job sanitizing and disinfecting and resetting so that I'm ready for the next gig. I also want to make sure that while I'm on set, I'm creating an efficient workflow to help things go as smoothly and safely as possible. Here's some things that I found to be helpful. Number one, have an honest and extensive conversation with whoever is hiring you before the job. It's so important to have an understanding of what's happening ahead of time so that you can discuss things like workflow, timing, and what your needs are. It's also important to understand what safety protocols are being put in place by production. This also gives you an opportunity to share your own. It's our responsibility to know what guidelines have been suggested by the union, if you're a member, Film and TV Commission, and the state that governs your area. These guidelines should be reviewed often as they are ever-changing. We should keep ourselves abreast of updated guidelines coming from the CDC and other credible health organizations. Two, be your own advocate and an advocate for the person who will be sitting in your chair. Production doesn't always have a clear understanding of what is involved to do our job safely, so sometimes we have to explain why something isn't the best option and provide suggestions or alternatives. We can operate safely if we're given the opportunity and have the right environment and tools to do so. Remember, the person sitting in your chair will not have protective covering on at some point, so it's important to advocate to have the safest working environment possible. Is a separate room with good airflow a possibility? If not, how big is the set? How many crew members will there be on set? Is there an area where makeup can be set up away from the traffic of the studio? Are there partitions available to create a barrier? If pictures or a video walkthrough can be provided, it can be helpful in mapping out a safe work area. Three, how are you getting to work? Makeup is working close to talent, remember that. How is exposure being minimized going to and from set? Are you driving? Is production providing transportation? If so, is it an individual car service being offered, or is it a production van? Is social distancing being observed in a production van? All important things to consider. Now that you know more about the job, it's time to plan out your workflow, including packing for the job, disinfection, and packing down after the work is done. Four, next, step up your own PPE. You walked in with a mask on. Now it's time to put on protective eye and clothing gear before you start cleaning. Wash those hands and get some gloves to protect your hands from the chemicals you'll be using. Five, before setting up your makeup, sanitation and disinfection need to happen. Sanitation is a fancy word for cleaning. Disinfection is the killing of germs, bacteria, and viruses. And sterilization is the destroying of a virus or bacteria. Time needs to be allowed for this process, and it is imperative that directions are read and followed of any product you're using to optimize effectiveness. Most products have a dwell time, which means the amount of time it takes for the product to do its thing. Make sure their product is effective for what it is being used on. If a product says it's only to be used on hard, non-porous surfaces, like this table, don't assume it will be effective on a porous surface like fabric. You will possibly need different products depending on the surface you're disinfecting. Don't forget about the chairs or any high-touch surfaces such as light switches and faucet handles. Six, now it's time to set up your makeup station. Wash those hands thoroughly. If that's not possible, use a hand sanitizer and gloves if needed. Put barriers down before putting your makeup or implements out. Keep everything closed and protected and only take things out as needed. I have items grouped by use in my kit, but find a system that works for you. Keeping everything closed up helps to prevent from possible exposure to contamination. It is also helpful to keep your kit as compact as possible so that you're using less items that will be needed to be disinfected and cleaned later. 7, use disposable implements or tools that can be sanitized and disinfected. Glass and stainless steel are examples of non-porous hard surfaces. Be careful with plastic. You know how a plastic container can stain or hold an odor of a food that was once in it? It might not be the best thing to use as a surface for makeup application. 8, use caution when disposing of items. This includes taking off a cape or disposable apron. Assume that everything potentially has COVID cooties. You want to roll things into themselves to avoid making any potential infection airborne. I have a trash can with a lid, and I also keep a few trash bags with drawstrings in case a covered trash can isn't available. 9, once I use an item, it doesn't go back into my kit. I know that it needs to go through my protocol in order to go back into my kit. I do wipe down the outside with disinfectant and spray the product with a makeup safe sanitizer. It still doesn't go back in my kit at that point, but that's me. All disposables are disposed of. If possible, I wash my used brushes with soap and water, but they still don't go back with their other friends in their brush holder. If I am not using a disposable cape or apron, washable ones are sprayed down with the appropriate disinfectant at the end of the day. They are still not introduced back into my kit. Everything used that day, even though it has been wiped down or sprayed with disinfectant, goes in a separate bag to be transported home for the next phase. And after I have completed additional steps at home, I quarantine the brushes and anything that was washable or wearable for 72 hours. If I were using the same brushes on the same talent, like for a TV show or film, I would use the same brushes on the talent without the quarantine happening. 10. Lastly, to make this process the most effective, it is imperative to understand about infectious disease, how they are spread, and how to keep from spreading them. COVID isn't the only game in town. Equally as important to understanding the process of sanitizing, which is cleaning, disinfecting, and sterilizing. Again, just because a process is effective in one situation doesn't mean it is in others. That's why we need to learn what to use, when, and why. Stay safe out there.